knowledge and experience are its ingredients. But hard work is that little salt that makes the dish more delicious. Greetings to you all. First of all, today I am really, really happy. Not because I was felicitated here, not because I am going to miss two or three lectures in my college, but because after many days, I have come to my high school and today I am standing before you. Let me be honest, no student, including me, like to listen to someone who gives the so-called Gyan. Last year when I was there and my senior was here, the only thing running in my head was the program innu 20-25 nimisha idre second period guarantees. I'm sure most of you are thinking the same right now. But friends, I request you all to consider whatever I say not as a gyan, but consider it as a suggestion. And the final decision is yours. So friends, teachers come to our classroom, do the lesson, give their 100%. But is the 100% given by the teacher in the classroom your 100% of understanding? Definitely not. It is just 50% of your understanding. The remaining 50% depends on how you practice, how you revise at home. So there is a saying, there is no elevator to success. You will have to take the steps. Thus, it is necessary to be focused and practice at home. Just reading will not help you. The reading should be effective. Consider a student. Let us say he studies for 1 hour a day. But will he be able to study the whole hour with full concentration? Definitely not. He may read or he may study to a maximum of 20 to 25 minutes with full concentration. The other 15-20 minutes, he may be physically holding a book, but mentally he will be in his own world. And the remaining part of the 1 hour, he will pass it by just looking at the clock with the 1 hour pass. So, we must avoid doing such things. Let's be focused on what we are doing. One more distraction that we face as students is due to the mobile phone. Friends, tell me, a sharp knife, is it a useful thing or a dangerous thing? The answer is it depends on the user. It may be used for good thing as well as bad thing, but it depends on the user. Similarly, mobile phone can affect you in a good way as well as a bad way. It depends on you, how you use it. I'm not saying don't use mobile phone. No, you use it. But there must be a limit. Half an hour a day, 1 hour a day, and not more than that. So, if I were to say other things, all this will account to 90% of your success. The other 10% depends on luck. And this luck will come into your favor. Will come into your favor with the blessings of your parents, blessings of teachers and elders. So do respect all of them. Friends, keep it in mind that according to English, failure may be part of it, failure may be opposite of success. But according to life, failure is a part of success and is the stepping stone of success. So work hard. And before, I would like to thank all the teachers, especially. They work so hard for us. They work so hard for the school. A big salute to all the teachers. You know, during the tough times, during lockdown time, they are the ones who approached us through online learning. They sent us the previous year question papers, maybe notes, maybe reference material through WhatsApp and other social media. So I really, really thank all the teachers for their effort they have put in. I'd also like to thank my parents, because guys, you come to know the importance of parents, the love the parents shower on you during, especially during the 10th board exams. They are the ones who take more tension than you. When you are sleeping peacefully, they are the ones who have the sleepless nights. When you are sitting for overnight study, They are the ones who come and ask you for coffee, snacks, so that you get refreshed. No, I have received all this support from my father, from my mother, so I'm really grateful for that. And yeah, I've taken a long time. So before concluding, I'd like to say one thing. If I'm not wrong, in the batch of my seniors, a girl named Swati scored 622. This year, the girl sitting there with a broad smile in her face, Nidhi Rao, scored 624. Hats off from my side. And now, next year, it's your duty to keep this graph going to its peak value. So it's your duty to score 625 out of 625. So guys, will you do it for me? Will you do it for your parents? Will you do it for your school? So thus, with this note, I conclude by saying that study while others are sleeping, work while others are talking, prepare while others are playing, and dream while others are wishing. Thank you.